So on our way to Mysore in Biradi, we stopped at Renukamba, the idli store where we had our breakfast, which was idli vada, and the idli was super soft. The chutney was yum, and I've never had such good idli. I can bet on that. So check out for the store on your way to Mysore. Thanks to the highway construction, we took 4 hours to reach Mysore city, but then it was already 12 and we were yet to reach our Airbnb. After a long journey, we finally reached Liva Nest, and here we decided to order in from the nearest restaurant, which the host of Airbnb also recommended. So we ordered some food from Patel Gardenia, and the food was delicious. It was simple. They have a wide range of variety that you can order from. So since we were a little far away from Mysore, this was the best place we could order in from. So the second day, SPR was highly recommended. So we came here for our first meal of the day, that is breakfast. It's a very fancy looking vegetarian restaurant which serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So here we are for our breakfast. We had to try the Mysore masala dosa, so we got that, some kesari bath, and other dishes, breakfast dishes that were available. Post our breakfast, we decided to go to Sapa Bakery, which was walkable distance from SPR. This is a German bakery in Mysore, which specializes in sourdough bread and gourmet snacks and some, pastries and donuts, etc. So we were here to parcel some and take it back to our Airbnb with us. It's a very small bakery in the bylands of Mysore, so don't be surprised if there's a long queue. And by the way, the ginger ale in Sapa Bakery is a must try, especially in the summer. And we went right around the time where the sun was out bright, shining bright on us, so ginger ale was a savior. While we waited for our donuts to get ready, we decided to recce this organic farmers marketplace next to Sapa Bakery, which also has a bookstore with wide range of categories. And they are basically a very new organic store which has a lot of different kinds of honey, different kind of oils to try. Day 3, on our way back to Bangalore, we decided to step into this very famous Pujari's fish land, and the entrance is glamorous and super grand with vintage cars and vintage two-wheelers on in the entrance. It did seem like a very fancy place to, have lunch or dinner, but they were famous for their seafood, so we had to give this place a try before we head to Bangalore. So hungry that we forgot to document what we ordered, but I can tell you the seafood here is epic, especially prawns and the gyros. This was all about a relaxing weekend. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.